So I haven't been very active with getting things posted. It's been, for one, it's been like 27 degrees outside every single day. So I haven't really had an off day in like a little while now. I went ahead and had Seth do a few things for me while I was at work. So he finished up the timing on this. Well, not like, he got the cams set because the shims that I had in there obviously were out of spec after I did it. And then the shims that I ordered were wrong. So I had to go back, order shims again. I'm actually going to send the other ones back today. So I had him shim everything while I was at work. Came home, I helped him put the valve cover on and all that fun stuff. And for some reason, it decided it wanted to be 67 degrees out. So we just started throwing parts on this thing.
Well, started putting this thing together and got a little eager to get it done, so I didn't film anything. But motor's all mounted up. Frame, my beautiful frame.
Yeah, yo. Every letter is love and every word's an oasis. Trying to reach new heights like a bird in a spaceship. And you're damn right, we've been working the late shift. Trying to see how far on planet Earth we can take it. This is poetry in motion, the mystery of why. Every motor is in motion and it's visually divine.
Yep,
on a
happened.
Roll like Timmy, and they're stuck in bad traffic. So when I rock at the bottom, looks like Buckingham Palace. I feel fucking fantastic, a Viking with the rhyme. That lightning in the sky mixed with Tyson and his prime. I tell it how it is and they got nothing to say. I tell the haters I love them just to fuck with their brains. Duck, I'm insane. My flow's like a swordfish. This is 100% straight up uncut raw shit. I can't be bamboozled, that's faker than a dollar sign. Beat me in their dreams and they wake up and apologize. Non-believers trying to piss in my boots. Don't they know they'll have to fly just to fit in my shoes? Got the world in my palm and my feet on the dash. So let them bitch and wish I wasn't the reason they rap shit. I'm trying to write a song with insight. So look past the mask, there's diamonds on the inside. We're unplugged and blessing me with magic. Our drift is in the air, but the question is, can you catch it?
Love that can set you free. Watching the sunset, you know the sea. And if you lift me above the highest mountain peak.
I'm a cowboy kid from DC with Marvelette as superheroes. Draining his Walkman battery, juice to zero. A teen with a dream, and since the whole start I've been like Quentin plotting from the video archives. So I direct my film like Jack Sparrow's compass. Cut six, shooting like a black barrel gunship. Just like when the rain and thunder hits the planet. Dreamt once in the clouds, now the mothership has landed. God damn it, spectacular. Lock it up and low, with that flip of the tongue and hit of the drum. Rock and fucking roll, yeah. I spark an idea ignited from my balls. Added to the 99 bottles of lightning on my wall. In a boat of hope on an ocean where the sharks live. Spitting fireflies to paint my poems in the darkness. Connectivity is in my stare. Shit, electricity is in the air. So throw your islands in the sky if you feel the vibe. Hip-hop is still alive every time we fly. And when I find a line like a rope, I can use it to lift me out the sea of disposable music. But you can't touch my soul cause that dog shit smells. I wanna be taken away like a cosmic spell. So no need to show me the money of bonded sales. Cause this song gives me the quan just like Rod Tidwell. And so
set you free. Watching the sun setting on the sea. And it can lift me above the highest mountain peak. And now I see life from my balcony.
Like, I mean, we stayed up till about 2:30 in the morning throwing parts at this thing. I actually had to work at 4:30, so I went to bed, took my hour nap, got up, went to work, came home yesterday from work, and we actually got fired up. I didn't really have time to get a video or anything. Like I said, we were up all night just throwing parts on this thing because it was warm. It was a little warm yesterday, so we got it fired up. I still have to wait on my wheels because I need to get the new spokes and the hubs and hub bearings and a couple other things. Well, wheel bearings, whatever. I think I'm saying a lot again. I just got to think about everything because we just put so much into this the last 2 days or so. So the entire motor is in there. Now, I got new foot pegs. The frame looks awesome. It kills me how you can't tell in this light how awesome this frame actually is. So let me just see if I can get it good. There we go. That's pretty. And I could never really get a good video, but it's a chameleon. So it's actually chameleon teal and purple. Certain angles it looks purple, certain angles it looks blue. It's hard to pick it up on a camera, but sweet. So frame, subframe, swing arm, everything really just went together immaculately. I mean, I had to have Seth help while I was getting some things together. I had him go ahead and hit some of the holes where it wasn't really from the powder coating, but there was a lot of sand and everything. So it wasn't really, well, it was from the powder coating, but it wasn't from the paint. Anywho, so I got the radiators on. The Cycro conversion kit, I'm actually like really, really excited about because it made this thing like way skinnier than I thought it would. So I'm very excited about that. I got a full FMF 4.1 exhaust. I actually went with the titanium slip-on and the carbon fiber, but I went with the stainless steel header. Don't ask why, just personal preference. Megabomb header, by the way. Let's see. So I got my shock. It's powder coated black now. Got it all on there. Swing arm. I had a problem with the brake seizing up. Hopefully the new fluid's going to help a lot. We went ahead and cleaned everything up in there. Let's see. What else is there? I can't get a good picture of it. Hopefully when I get it outside, I can get a really good video of it for you guys. Seat cover, well, the seat entirely isn't on because I have a new seat cover. I just don't have a stapler, so I gotta pick that up today. I'm gonna go drop the wheels off today. I should have them back in a couple days. So I'm gonna go ahead and drop the wheels off. Should have them back in a couple days. I got a fresh set of tires somewhere. I couldn't tell you where right now, but they're somewhere. So I'm going ahead and get this thing fired up. It's got a couple little rattles on it that you'll probably hear, like for instance, mostly the rear brake, but that's just because I don't have any wheels. I actually had to have Seth help hold the front end down for me the last time I started it, so I may or may not be able to get this thing started for you guys, but I wanted to get a good video of it. So hopefully I can get it turned over. It's got a lot more compression now, and with no rear wheel, it's hard to keep from knocking it off the stand, and by all means, that's the last thing I want to do. Woohoo. That's sketchy. Might be a little cold.